It's Samuel from How to FAQ, and today I'm going to be showing you the top four free cloud storage services, and there's some great ones on the list. So let's get started. The first one is Google Drive. So you can just type in Google Drive into any search engine. Normally comes up first, and you'll see there's Google Drive, and you can just click on it, and you get 15 gigabytes free. Every Google account gets it, and you probably already have a Gmail account or a YouTube account or whatever, and that's all linked in with Google, and that gets you 15 gigabytes free, so you can store some pictures on that. And there are ways through Google Maps contributions where you can get up to 100 gigabytes, I believe, so you can actually get quite a bit free, and it's quite easily laid out. The user interface is very good. I'll just show you. Click go to Drive. And this is all synced in with Google Docs and Google Sheets and Google Slides, and that's like a online editor, so you can do everything you can do with Microsoft Word, but online. So that's much easier. If you see here, got a few things here. And see, it says 15 gigabytes of free storage. And the reason why it's so much easier with Google Drive is it stores all your documents that you've made with Google and all your things. It's all stored in the same place, so you're never going to lose it. Right, I'll show you the next one. Right, the next one is Dropbox. Everybody knows Dropbox, I reckon. It does give you some free space, about 5 gigabytes, I think. It might have increased as storage space changes all the time. Yeah, and you can actually get more storage space by sharing it with a friend, and if they then sign up for Dropbox, then you actually get like 500 megabytes or something. So, and I think you can get up to 16 gigabytes. I personally, I think if you have an account for over 2 years, you can get up to 50 gigabytes. I personally have around 60 gigabytes, and I haven't paid anything, and you can get this stuff free. So yeah, very good. It's still very easy to use. Most apps work with it, you know, all these backup things. You can have a camera upload happening from your phone and all these things. And that means that all your photos are backed up all the time, wherever you are, you can access them. So that's a really good feature to have. Right, the next one is OneDrive. So this is one of these cloud services made by Microsoft. And Microsoft has done a good job, I have to admit. They do have a camera upload, and with certain new phones, I think as early as the S5, Samsung Galaxy S5, if you have that phone, Samsung gives you like 100 gigabytes free. And I had an S5, and I got the 100 gigabytes free, and I've been using it to store my photos and backing everything up. And I have to say, it's really good, because it means that you don't have to have everything locally and think about the risk, and sometimes there's problems on your phone, you have to factory reset it. You don't have to think about that risk, because it's all backed up on OneDrive. So yeah, it's free. I mean, it works with every Windows computer, and that's a nice thing. In Windows 10, you can sync it very nicely with OneDrive and all your tablets and stuff. So yeah, nothing doesn't really work with OneDrive. Right, now onto the final cloud storage. It's called Mega.nz. Now, I think this is probably up there with some of the best ones. Not a lot of people know about it. I think it's a New Zealand company. And I might be wrong. And basically, it allows you to store up to 50 gigabytes of data free, and it uses very good encryption, which means that if there was somehow it was hacked or anything, like I think Dropbox has been hacked before, if this Mega.nz was hacked, it'd be very hard for anybody to get your data, and it'd probably be almost impossible. So it's probably the safest option out of all of them, and you do get 50 gigabytes free. I mean, you can store a lot of photos with 50 gigabytes, a lot of music, a lot of video. So I think if you want to start off, you can use multiple cloud storage, you know, that's probably a good thing to use. Like for me, I use OneDrive, Mega.nz, and I use Google Drive for like school stuff. So storing all my student documents and things like that, very good for Google Drive, because I can just use Google Docs, sync it all in very nicely. And Dropbox I do use to store some less important documents, but yeah, it's very, all these four can be used together, and because they're free, it allows you to do it without having to worry about the cost, even though some of them you can pay and get more data. But yeah, I want to thank you for watching this video. Do drop a like on this video and subscribe to the channel, because we're going to have new great tutorials, top fives or top fours of the best, like social media, Google Drives, like cloud storage and things like that. And I'm going to do my best to upload more frequently, so do subscribe and comment down below what you thought of the video. And yeah, thanks for watching. Goodbye.